I am becoming more powerful than any Jedi has ever dreamed of, and I'm doing it for you.
Hayden's character is obviously the one that's really going through the change, and mine is much more just reactive to that. Padme has a pretty centered self, that it's not that she goes through this big change internally, but that external things are changing around her, and she has to sort of make decisions to cope with that. If she had some different concept of, government or what's right or morality, she might have been able to stay with him, if her loyalties to him were, just sort of above everything. But Padme is a politician. She'd been a leader of many people.
Naboo's system has been invaded by the droid army.
This is sort of combining being a woman with being a politician, which is an interesting combination we don't see much of. I think the role is really sort of what the true meaning of feminism in my sort of interpretation of it.
Look, whatever happens out there, follow my lead. I'm not interested in getting into a war here. As a member of the Senate, maybe I can find a diplomatic solution to this mess.
I think the true feminism is bringing what is particular to women, because we are different, that's undeniable, to the opportunities that men have. So it's not, going into some place and just behaving like a man, or necessarily desiring what men want just because you can get it.
And together, you and I can rule the galaxy.
And so, rather than being consumed with the thirst for power, as many of the people around her do, both men and women, she stays true to her compassion and her belief in democracy and humanity.
If this body is not capable of action, I suggest new leadership is needed.